Hello everyone. Today we will be continuing with our dragon coloring. A beautiful purple pinkish dragon. Let's just put these nicely here so that we can pick whichever color we want. And put this away. Maybe even further away. Here, just in case, and let's get to our drawing. And let's just pick the colors that we're going to be using. Just a second. Okay, I don't want the camera to be touched by the table constantly, you know, shaking. That'll be very good for your eyes, I'm guessing. Okay, so maybe we can go with this, and actually, maybe a little bit red could be nice. Not that one. That one is a bit orangish, I think. Or is it? Yeah, this one is a bit orangish. Okay, so maybe we can put some pink in the future. But for now, let's stick to these colors. So, how have you been guys doing? Have you been sleeping well? Pretty much since yesterday, I guess. Or whenever you're watching this video. I slept pretty well myself. Although I did wake up at 6:15 and then couldn't go back to sleep again. But considering that last week I was going to sleep, waking up around 6, actually not around, exactly at 6, and this week I'm waking up at 7, 6:15, doesn't sound very absurd, I guess. So, yeah. I decided to wake up earlier. About a month ago or so, I changed my sleep schedule, and so far it's been actually pretty cool. I wake up at 6 or 7, as I said. This week I started waking up at 7 o'clock, and I just go for a walk for like half an hour, morning walk, especially when there's nobody else on the street. You can see like one or two people maybe, if you're lucky enough. Even though some people don't like communicating with others in the morning, I still try to get some good mornings from people forcefully, which is nice when it works out, of course. And that walk actually cheers me up quite a bit. Like, it's probably my best, like the best part of my day, I'd say. It wakes me up, especially these days. It's, you know, pretty cold weather, so it's helpful. And I'm just listening to music, walking around, sometimes even taking off the headphones, earphones, just, you know, listening to the wind. It's pretty cool. Obviously, you know, when the cars start going around, depending on what time I start my walk, if it's like around 8:30 and I'm still outside, I start hearing, you know, lots of cars, and that part is not my absolute favorite, I'd say, but still, it's pretty cool to take walks in the morning. It cheers you up, and also if there's you know, any sunlight, then it's just absolutely amazing. Boosts morale, I'd say. At least mine. Yeah, and so I then just come home and pretty much chill, and then have some breakfast, and you know, just do whatever I want to do, whatever I can do with only one hand. You might have seen in my previous video, I'm wearing a brace. Currently it's drying because we just washed it. But yeah, I have something wrong with my wrist, left wrist. So unfortunately, I am unable to use that hand that much. So during the day, I do whatever I can with only this hand, which is, you know, coloring. If, you know, I'm lucky and it doesn't hurt too much, I can do other activities like watching movies, TV series, even playing games only with the mouse, like Sims, for example, I recently got into. I remember playing like Sims 1 back in the day, and then came Sims 2 and it was like super fancy, and now there's like Sims 4, but it's actually pretty fun. I got into it again. There's not much, you know, not many games you can play with one hand only. I usually go for, you know, like, I don't know, first person shooters or MMORPGs, but well, one hand is not enough for those, let's just say. But it's going pretty well. I found some other like indie games here and there. Those are also fun. Again, only with the mouse. So it's working out pretty well. So yeah, all day long I'm basically just doing whatever I can. And until I go back to work, this is how it will be, keeping my sanity as much as I can. And then finally, when I get back to work, things might get back to normal. And yeah, in the evening, you know, around 10:30, 11-ish, I usually stop whatever I'm doing, computer, phone, whatever, and turn off all the electronics and just make some tea and start drawing. I mean, coloring. I also do some drawing here and there, but it's not as, let's say, easy as just coloring. For the brain, I mean. Because if you're, you know, drawing, you're trying to pay attention to certain things, trying to make the drawing look like something else, and the head is kind of working, like the brain is kind of working, and it doesn't allow you to go that sleepy. It sure helps, but I feel like coloring requires less attention. It's, you know, I'm doing it mainly for the therapeutic aspect of it, so I feel like coloring helps more in that way. I'm thinking at some point I should change colors, like, you know, go from one color to the other, like I did in these ones, you know, like somehow change the shade or directly change the color to another one, or somehow make the transition like I did here. I guess we will see what happens after I do this bit. After I finish this, and I think this will be the last one, then I will get the other color and start doing some transitions and see how it works. Whoops, I forgot about my chamomile tea. Delicious. Do you guys like chamomile tea? I do very much. A few years later, when I was living alone one day, I got food poisoning without realizing it. I was in a lot of pain, and I did a lot of, like, I tried a lot of things to get rid of that pain, and nothing helped, and eventually, while I was struggling to even sit straight, I was like, you know, in weird positions, holding my stomach. I thought, okay, I'm gonna make myself some chamomile tea and maybe it'll help me. And I made myself some chamomile tea, and well, by the time I could drink it, it was already like kind of like lukewarm. I drank it and it genuinely helped me, and I couldn't even change my position. Like, I was holding my stomach and just drinking this tea like from the side of my mouth basically, and it did actually help me a lot. And ever since that day, like the second huge event, I'm considering chamomile tea as the like best cure for anything. And it does help me get, you know, calm and even sleepy. So if anybody is having issues and you haven't tried chamomile tea yet, I suggest you give it a try. It's miraculous, seriously. Just amazing. So yeah, that's why the chamomile tea. Some people don't like the taste of it, but I actually enjoy the taste as well. It's not only for the, you know, use, good use and benefits of it, but also for the taste. At the same time, I'm trying to determine in which direction I'm going to go with this drawing. It doesn't look that bad, but I'm wondering where to change the colors. Maybe I can change the color to red, like really fast, right around here. That might actually work. But I think we should follow the same approach here. At least this side should be purple. Even this bit could be purple, but we can change the color of this to a little bit like pinkish purple, like we did here. Maybe let's do this so that it's kind of similar. There we go. And we go like this. Okay. Every now and then this hand hurts, but trying to focus on this and just trying to calm down. I cannot do thumbs up with this hand, for example. Just ridiculous, but it is true. And I forgot to mute my phone, so that's going to be an issue in a few minutes when my alarm goes off. The alarm that tells me to stop drawing and just go to sleep. I like that alarm too. I have a lot of alarms for a lot of things, which helps me not think about, you know, too many things at once. Just empty my mind as much as I can. I just keep, you know, working with to-do lists, alarms, reminders, a little bit, let's say, dependency, too much dependency on technology. But when you have too much going on, I guess that's one of the things that can help you. I could also have some sort of like a calendar kind of thing, but I like using my phone for those things. Okay, so we did that part. Now we can continue with this. By the way, earlier I was actually playing Sims just like half an hour ago or so. And I mean, that's when I stopped. about half an hour ago, but until then, for hours, I've been collecting mod files. There are so many mods, so many new hairstyles that people created, clothing, different outfits. It's amazing what the community has made. I just got lost in all of them, and I'm not even halfway done, most probably. There was so much to do, so many of them to try. It's seriously, I love when, community just is so active and so much is created. It's just wonderful. There was I think the medieval clothing that I saw were for Sims 3, so I don't think I'll be using them. I haven't gotten to try a lot of them. There was even one that was eyes, for the eyes, and they made it so realistic. Like when you're selecting eyes, it's just wow, really. It's a whole new deal. Every time I looked, it's like color within a color within a color kind of thing. So realistic, it's just mesmerizing. I wanted to play Sims for since the morning, and yet I ended up just losing myself inside the, in those mod websites. Eventually, I'll get to play and, try them out, but we'll see how it goes. Okay, after this, I think I need to end the video because it might have been a little too much for the day, and I don't want my alarm to freak anybody out. So we can continue tomorrow, I guess. Right. Oops, that was a bit loud. So thank you very much, guys, for joining me, guys and gals. And